Good evening, teachers, dear parents, beloved friends, ladies and gentlemen. A memorable night to you. My name is Christina Giaclinto, and it is a great privilege for me to be standing here in front of you. As a graduate of the class of 2017, I express the happiness that I feel in my heart today. They say people only remember the first and forget the rest. But I believe that these years have been a journey, and we will take many memories with us. I have been part of the Bridges family since I started pre-K at St. Peter's. Since I started going to the Bridges Academy, I felt like I was part of another family. Thanks to Ms. Lee, Madame Cadet, and Mrs. Tuma, I have been inspired to travel to different countries to learn about the many different cultures. Thanks to my gym and health teacher, Mrs. Sara, who has inspired me to become a therapist and help kids when I get older. I want to give a shout out to Mrs. Attar. She treats me as if I was her third child. In fact, I'm pretty sure I have called her mom before. She inspired me to write short stories and poems. I constantly carry around a notebook with me just so I can write something new. I want to say thank you to my grandma, Barbara Giaclinto, for being my role model and for helping me remember to not eat junk food all the time. I also want to say thanks to my dad, Stuart Schwartz, for getting engaged to my mom and for engaging in learning of others' lives. Our lives wouldn't be the same without you. And of course, I wouldn't forget to say thanks to my best friend, my role model, my mom, Lisa Giaclinto. You, Mom, you helped me pick my future school. You helped me become a better person. You taught me what's right and what's wrong. And most important, you chose me to become a daughter, a part of your life. If it wasn't for you, I wouldn't be here right now saying this speech. I also need to say thank you to Margaret for being there for me ever since I was a little tot. You took care of my brother. You were there for us even though we can be extremely annoying. You helped us through the tough times, cared for and pampered us when we needed it, and most of all, you loved us like there was no tomorrow. You, Margaret, are a wonderful woman, and you deserve the best of the best. I love you all so, so much, and I wouldn't know what I would be doing without all of you. In my class, there is this one specific, smart, friendly, and lovely girl who has stuck with me ever since pre-K. She makes me smile through the toughest times. She helps me with my homework and classwork. She doesn't mind if I rant to her about all the most silly things that are going on in my life. She treats me as if I was her sister. We love creating inside jokes, and we even have a book full of our inside jokes. We also love using each other as pillows. That lovable girl is named Lily Jetty. Lily, without you, I would be so one and only. You are the light that outshines my darkest days. Lily, you made a humongous impact on my life. And even though we are going to different high schools, we have a special bond that I'm sure will last forever. All of us are blessed with talents and are worth graduating, and this is what this day is all about. How many times have we imagined what this day would be like? I have to say, I have thought about this day so many times, I could have remembered every imagined scene. But I believe that this scene in front of me is better than all the ones that I have imagined. Who would have thought that our then nervous 13 or 14-year-old selves would survive to roller coaster ride in middle school and would be here listening to the speech? We have come a long way in our journey indeed. Now that we have passed our challenges in middle school, it's time for us to move on to a bigger fight, high school. The lessons we have learned in the past will surely help us get through the next stage, but we also need to remember that all of those formulas, mandalas, everything we have memorized, they are not the only things that will help us through. We also need to retain the things we have learned other than the academics, gaining the courage to stand in front of the class where we can barely work the nerve to talk to the person next to us, having the dedication to complete all our math homework when the only thing we actually know about it is the fact that we need to solve it. Those are but some of the things that we have learned about ourselves that go beyond our textbooks. And there is yet another thing we all need to remember. It is a lesson that I learned through the years, to learn to appreciate others and to remember that we cannot stand on our own. Of course, we solve problems and we solve problems by ourselves, answer our tests individually, and go through our everyday lives on our own. But one cannot deny how important the people around us are. Our parents, friends, teachers, even the bus driver, and the ladies and men who are on lunch duty, all of them have played a vital role in helping us be where we are now. And for the teachers that I have not mentioned, Mrs. Blackford and Dr. Caruso, I want to say thank you for my years at Bridges. Once again, congratulations.